Another first in this year of new challenges and new normal. The magazine Scientific American is endorsing a candidate for president for the first time in its 175-year history. Democrat Joe Biden gets that honor. Scientific American explaining its decision this way on Twitter. The 2020 election is literally a matter of life and death. We urge you to vote for health, science, and Joe Biden for president. Laura Helmuth is the editor-in-chief of Scientific American. Laura, thank you so much for joining us. I want to get into some of the reasons why in a minute, but first I want to get into the idea. So you're breaking a 175-year tradition. When you went around the room with your team, or maybe this was done virtually in the new normal we live in, was there any resistance into getting a magazine that's rooted in science and data involved in politics?
Yeah, so we took the decision very seriously. You don't break a 175-year tradition without a really good cause. But when we went around to the editorial staff, it was unanimous, and it wasn't that long a discussion. We all agreed that, you know, all the evidence shows that Trump has just been catastrophic for science and for public health and for the environment. And Joe Biden has, you know, really smart policies that should make the world better. So we felt like it was our duty to speak up.
And people should read the editorial, whether they agree or disagree. They should read it, because you talk about COVID, you talk about climate change, but you also talk about the EPA. You talk about a whole number of issues there, and what the president has done versus what Joe Biden says he would do. Here's a piece of the editorial endorsing Joe Biden. The evidence and the science show that Donald Trump has badly damaged the United States and its people because he rejects evidence and science. The most devastating example is his dishonest and inept response to the COVID-19 pandemic. A bit later, you say Joe Biden, in contrast, comes prepared with plans to control COVID-19, improve health care, reduce carbon emissions, and restore the role of legitimate science in policymaking. It is interesting that we have to have a conversation in the middle of a pandemic, with Sally making landfall, with the wildfires out west. We're having a conversation about whether climate change is real and we should follow science in a pandemic. That's kind of nuts.
It's ridiculous. I mean, science has never been more important, and it's never been more clear that science is important, and it shouldn't be a political issue, and yet it is. This time it really is.
And so let's listen. Just this week, the climate issue, obviously, the president went out to the West Coast after not saying much about the wildfires for weeks. The president went out to the West Coast. Joe Biden gave a climate change speech, and if voters need a choice on any one issue, here's a choice.
It'll start getting cooler.
You just watch. I wish science agreed with you.
Hey, well, I don't think science knows, actually.
We have to act as a nation. It shouldn't be so bad that millions of Americans live in the shadow of an orange sky. And they're left asking, is doomsday here?
I know this from my 9-year-old, but what is it like to be a journalist who specializes in science to constantly hear the president of the United States confuse climate with weather?
Oh, yeah, it's just shocking. And actually, science does know. Like, there is just overwhelming evidence that human activity is changing the climate in ways that exacerbate wildfires and the 5 hurricanes we have in the Gulf right now. I mean, this is not a controversial thing for science. The data is in. We know that this is happening. To see him just rejecting, not only rejecting science, but then amplifying conspiracy theories and misinformation. So, you know, we talk about the signal to noise ratio, and he just keeps adding noise at a time when we need there to be clear information for people.